Okay, this is KISS flight controller, default PIDs, totally default. And we're just gonna try, you know, this will just be, I'm sure that the PIDs will probably be too low for my preferences, and we'll try to raise them and see where they go. But for the time being, let's just fly it as it is. I have adjusted the rates to match my normal preferred rates based on my beta flight rates and just based on a little bit of test flying. That's pretty good, frankly. The defaults are. I don't know what that kind of scrabbly sound is in the motor. Doesn't seem good. Yaw rate could be higher. Yaw rate is a little higher than, or a little lower than pitch rate, you see? Yaw rate's a little too low. We'll bring that up. Overall though, it flies really nice. Really smooth yaw performance. I'm not sure if I could put it any better than that. Really, I see what people mean about the KISS rates. I'm not sure I could put it into words, but that doesn't sound like a good noise. That doesn't sound like a good noise. Let's see if any of the motors are out of whack. Well, none of the motors are super hot. They're warm, but they're not super hot. I don't know what that kind of chirpy noise, I guess, is. So let's fly it a little more on this battery and just finish out this battery, and then we'll go from there. It sounds like D-term oscillation, to tell you the truth. Defaults are really good. I'm not sure how much I would improve on this, honestly. I'm not sure how much I would improve on this, to tell you the truth. Oh, hang on. We're still on. This isn't defaults. This is final glides. Why didn't it save? Damn it. Okay, so that was flying with final glides preset that I downloaded from the PIDs database. Let's try the defaults. I don't know why the defaults didn't take. So let me do this one with the defaults. And I'm also going to adjust the rates, like I said. It felt like, to me, with roll at 80, when I flew it yesterday, like it was a little faster than I wanted it, a little faster than pitch. So let's try that. Okay, so now this is actually with the defaults. Much softer feel, for sure, because of the lower P gain. I can absolutely feel it. Roll rate, it's still too low. It needs to come up. Upwash handling is very good. feel like it's very controllable. Very stable on throttle punches, no destabilization, no pitching forward or backward. The way the rolls come on and they start and end is very pleasant. It has a very sort of smooth beginning and ending. I like very much. It's different. It's different. Also, I feel like it's very sort of controllable in here. I'm not sure. There's not tending to sort of slide out in the turns here. Very smooth turns there, you see. I'm not having to do a lot of adjustments mid-turn. Has a very smooth character. Okay, well, so for my copter, at least, Final Glide's preset had D gains that were too high. You could hear the crickety-like noise in the motors, even at idle, and definitely during flying. The motors were coming down. They weren't too hot. They were definitely hotter than they are now, though. So let's take the Final Glide tune as sort of our top end. And the D on pitch was like at 18. And that was probably the one that was giving me trouble because the other one was like at 11, which it wasn't. That doesn't seem very high.
So we'll come back here and we'll plug back in and we'll see what we're going to do. I feel like the copter was softer than I would like it, although the prop wash handling here was very good. And certainly somebody would like to fly it this way, like as a maybe an acro flyer who doesn't need the absolute sharpest performance. So let's go on over to the rates. Well, I still feel like we need to raise the roll rate a little bit. I can just put it at 80, I guess. Oh, no, not 90. Yeah, okay. Save that. And let's go to configuration, and we want to raise. I definitely want to raise. Well, I don't know what's. Oh, something ain't right, friends. Something ain't right at all. Whoa.
RSSI telemetry lost. Telemetry recovered.
Oh, that's good. I'm glad that came back the way it was. So we're definitely going to raise our P gains. Our I gain seems like it's pretty good. I did not see any pitching forward or back when I punched the throttle. So let's raise the P. And again, I'm going to go refer back to Final Glide's tune that I downloaded. And I believe his roll was around in the 4s. And his pitch was actually in the 7s. And it seemed to be flying pretty good. I'm going to just take let's take roll to 4 and pitch to, let's say, 5.5. And I'm doing that because pitch is usually on a copter, this style of frame. The weight is more distributed along the pitch axis, so you need a little more P gain on pitch than roll to get the same feel. So I'm going to just go up here. I know that roll was at 4 on the first flight. Pitch was around 7, but I feel like 7 might be higher than I want because it'll bring out the prop wash, especially given that I'm definitely not going to want to raise my D very much at all because it was bringing out those crickety-like shutters, those oscillation sounds. So here's where we're going to be. We're going to save that. And we'll get another battery and get going. What I'm going to be looking for here is a sharper stick feel. And I'm going to be paying attention to how much the higher P gains bring out the prop wash oscillations. With flight controllers as good as they're getting today, prop wash oscillations are really the major limitation on how high you can afford to raise your P gains. It used to be that you would get kind of crazy unflyable oscillations if your P gains were too high, and these days you can fly with really radically high P gains and still have a acceptably controllable copter, if not optimal, but you could still be in the air.
I hear the oscillation there, but it feels still pretty controllable. We'll have to check the high def footage to see if it... Oh, we got a little bounce back there. See? A little bounce back after that roll that wasn't there before. We'll have to check the high def footage to see how visible it is. The motors sound a little squibblier now. There's a kind of a high-pitched squeaking that wasn't there before, which I wouldn't normally expect from bringing up P-gain. You can hear it at idle, too. A little bit of bounce at the end there. I'm going to bring... I definitely don't like the sound that the motors are making, that kind of high-pitched, squeaky oscillation. I don't know what to call it, really. I definitely don't like that, and I don't want them to be doing that if I can avoid it. It just doesn't feel... I mean, it may be that that's something that the KISS ESCs do that is not a problem. I don't know, but it doesn't seem like it's good for them to be doing that. That feels to me like the sound of excess D gain, except we know we haven't changed the D gain, so it has to be something P-term related, but yeah.
Let's take the pitch P gain down to 4.5. I still think pitch should be higher than roll, but let's take it down to 4.5. And we're also seeing a little bit of bounce back at the end of the rolls. So I'm going to raise D, but I'm only going to raise it just the tiniest bit, because I don't want to bring out any noise or bad behavior.
I'm going to be listening for those like cricket oscillations, which I associate with D-term, but must not be the case in this case. Good prop wash there. No prop wash. No visible prop wash, really. That's really good right there. Littlest bit of oscillation there. I'm being very gentle with the throttle. Let's see how our big... The bounce got bigger there. I raised D gain, but the bounce there is huge, actually. It seems like it didn't make it better. Very smooth there. Very smooth there. I like how when I sort of center the stick, the copter really holds attitude very well. It holds attitude very well. There's not any sort of uncommanded motion. It's very good. Very good, very smooth and controllable.
So we raised the D gain to unroll to try and get the get that bounce back after the roll fixed, but it didn't fix it. Let's take it back down to 10. And I guess we're just gonna lower, let's try 3.75 here. I don't want to raise it anymore because I'm really worried about bringing out that noise. We seem pretty good on pitch. Let's take the pitch down just a smidge as well, just to see if things smooth out a little without sacrificing too much in terms of sharpness. That's what we're going to do.
Very smooth. Very smooth. Very nice. Very nice. I'm hearing a little bit of shuddering in the motors, but that's okay. It's happening during times when prop wash is happening, so the aerodynamic situation is changing rapidly. Oh yeah, that's nice. Nothing that's problematic. Conk. Yeah, I think that's a pretty good tune right there. I would stop there. Nothing bad, very controllable, sharp enough, very smooth. Yeah, there's definitely something to this claim that KISS has some kind of mojo in its rates or how whatever it's doing. It doesn't feel sloppy. It just feels very smooth and controllable. It doesn't feel razor sharp. Like if you were to take Betaflight's P-term set point weight and D-term set point weight all the way to the right, every single little stick movement, bang, 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 making the copter move. But I'm not sure that's a good thing, necessarily, depending on your style of flying. This feels very smooth and controllable. The copter, especially during turns or other sort of slow, smooth, continuous movements, like a slow backflip, the copter seems to move very predictably and doesn't seem to have any uncommanded motion in the middle, like where it's sort of speeding up or slowing down in the middle of the move. Or if you punch the throttle or something, it becomes destabilized a little bit. Oftentimes, if you're doing like a slow backflip, at the end, when you stop the backflip and recenter the stick, the copter will sort of stop abruptly and kind of settle in an unpleasant way, in a way that sort of disrupts the flow of the move. And this doesn't seem to be doing that. So, there you go.